Hello, my friends. God bless each and every one of you. It is the 11th day of November 2019. It is Veterans Day. It is a day for remembrance of all veterans. I served in the U.S. Army when I got out of high school. So many served this nation proudly, but a lot of them did not come home. So many fell on the fields of battle throughout many, many wars that this nation's been involved in, all the way back to the Revolutionary War when we fought for our independence from England. So it is a day of remembrance, but it's also a day, if you think about it this way, it's a day to be thankful for everything that you've got, for a loving family, for parents, and most importantly, that you know and love the Lord, that you know and have accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior. And if you see this video and you have not accepted Jesus as your personal Savior, what are you waiting for? None of us are promised tomorrow. And remember, the Bible says, the Lord tells us our lives are but a vapor. We're here and gone in an instant. And it's so true. It is so true. So if you don't know your Lord, know the Lord, I'm sorry, I'm tired. If you don't know the Lord as your personal Savior, what a better time than to do it on a day of remembrance like this for the United States. What a day. All you have to do is ask the Lord to forgive you of your sins. Ask Him to come into your heart. And my friends, He will. That is the most wonderful thing about it at all. He will come into your heart and you will be a new creature in Christ. That is absolutely wonderful. That is why they call it being born again. Because as the scholars in Jesus' time asked them, they did not understand what born again meant. They went to Jesus and asked Him, how can we physically be born again? We cannot re-enter our mother's wombs. And Christ told them, that is not what I mean. He was talking about spiritual rebirth. And if you truly accept Jesus Christ into your life, and I mean truly accept Him, my friends, it is an absolute joy. It is something like I can never, there's not a word on this earth that I can even bring forth from my mouth that could even compare to the feeling of having your sins, those burdens lifted off of you. And it is instantaneously. But you have to mean it. So many that don't believe in God, I often run into, they always want proof. They always want this, you know, irrefutable proof. They want this something they can touch, something they can taste, something they can smell. You know, this is what the non-believing world always asks of believers. They want that proof. You know, we gotta have proof. We gotta have proof. It was even like that in Jesus' time. Don't forget, they crucified Christ because they didn't believe He was the Son of God. They put Him to death. It's no different today. But there is a way. And I say this to a lot of people that don't believe in God. And I try to tell them, if they do this one thing and they do it with a sincere heart, they'll get their proof. They'll get it. They'll get it in bucket loads. And what I tell them, and I tell all non-believers that I come in contact with, the same thing when they like I said, when they got to have that proof. I tell them, when you're home and you're in bed by yourself or whatever, and wherever you got some peace and quiet, close your eyes and ask the Lord to reveal Himself to you. And guess what? If you do that with sincerity and a sincere heart, I promise you, the Lord will reveal Himself to you. You will know He is your Lord and Savior. You will know it. But so many do it jokingly and mockingly, and they don't mean it, and therefore it just goes right over their head. But I'm telling you right now, as you're looking at me on this camera, if you truly want to know that God is real, then do that. Ask him to reveal himself and do it with a sincere heart. Don't do it jokingly and mockingly, because you're not going to get nothing that way. But if you really, honestly, you want that proof like so many non-believers always squawk about, they want that proof, they got to have that proof. Well, I'm telling you a way to find out. God will reveal himself to you. I promise you, without a doubt, he will. The question is, do you really want to know? Do you really want that proof? And what a wonderful day than a day of remembrance for veterans across this nation. What a wonderful day for you to give your life to the Lord. You can't ask for a better day. Any day. Any day. It doesn't matter if it's a Monday, a Saturday. It doesn't matter what day of the week it is. It could be Christmas. It could just be a regular old Tuesday in August. That is the perfect day for you to accept Christ into your life. Because as I said earlier, none of us are promised tomorrow. And there's one thing I want to say before I stop. You do not want to leave this earth. You do not want to take your final breath on this earth and not know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. Because then, when you stand before the Almighty, you will taste what is called the second death. You will be cast into the lake of fire where you will be tormented forever and ever. I'm not trying to tell you that to scare you. I'm not trying to do anything of that sort. I'm telling you the gospel truth that is plain and simple in the Word of God. It is right there in the Word of God. All you got to do is find out for yourself. So, as I close this out, I hope you all have a wonderful Veterans Day. And if you have veterans in your family like myself, I have some brothers also that served along with me and my father, who is no longer with us. He fought in the war. Thank them. If you have neighbors that fought or even served, thank them. Because believe me, it makes a difference. It really does. When people come up to me and thank me at times, believe me, it makes a difference. It warms the heart. Have a wonderful, wonderful evening. God bless each and every one of you. Take care, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.